the 23rd of this month. That, I fear, is the worst of all. It is the Sabbat for the undead.
What significance has that?
There are satanic circles which govern our fate and the fate of this earth, perhaps even the universe. Now, throughout history, there are certain times, certain dates, which are marked by awesome catastrophes. Each event is carefully plotted, and a definite pattern emerges. Every disaster this world has ever suffered coincides with the point wherein these circles meet and cross. In this century alone, they heralded the outbreak of two devastating world wars.
And another disaster is imminent?
Could be.
The 23rd, that's the day after tomorrow.
Now, this must happen tomorrow at midnight.
Right, even sooner.
At that hour, the devil holds the balance of power. He marshals his disciples, the living and the dead.
In satanic covens, it is a celebration of supreme blasphemy, the Sabbat for the undead.
I've heard of the witches' Sabbat.
Now, this date is much more important, more profound, even more significant than the night of Valpurgis. Now, Keeley said the bacillus had to be ready by the 23rd. Why? A date chosen by Dracula himself, the 23rd day of this 11th month. The emerging pattern, you see, the night of the soulless ones.
And in the turmoil and fear that follows, a group of warped men emerge to take control. A politician, a soldier, an industrialist, a landowner.
But Dracula would eventually end up with a totally barren earth.
With any disease and dead bodies to feed on, surely even the vampire himself would perish.
Perhaps deep in his subconscious, that is what he really wants. An end to it all. He is a cursed immortal, existing on violence, fear, and dread. But suppose he, now just suppose he yearns for final peace. What then? He'd want to bring down the whole universe with him. The ultimate revenge. Thousands dying of the plague. Like the shadow of death itself, one figure scything its way through the terror and anguish. Count Dracula. It is the biblical prophecy of Armageddon.